हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो टुडे बिकॉज ऑफ सम नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम सो इंस्टेड ऑफ टेकिंग लेक्चर ऑन जूम सो फर्स्ट आई विल रिकॉर्ड दिस वीडियो एंड देन आई एम गोइंग टू अपलोड दिस वीडियो ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल दैट इज माइक्रोबायोलॉजी बाय संतोष नपते. सो आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज फ्रॉम पेपर सेकंड दैट इज Fundamentals of Microbiology, and in that we are starting this unit that is sterilization techniques. So in sterilization techniques we will study that different methods of sterilization that includes physical methods, chemical methods. So before studying that different methods of sterilization, so first we will see what is sterilization and why that sterilization is important. So the sterilization, it is the process by which all microorganisms are killed by using a specific method. So killing of all these microorganisms, that is simply called as sterilization. And the main importance of sterilization includes: one is that is to prevent the contamination in sterile products, because there are so many products are there including our foods or vegetables, so that get contaminated from different sources of microorganisms. So to prevent such contamination, that sterilization process is carried out, or if that products are contaminated, so they get sterilized by using different methods. Second important is that is to prevent transmission of pathogenic microorganisms which are responsible for causing diseases in plants, animals and human beings, because we know that large number of diseases in plants, animals and humans, these are caused by different types of microorganisms, or that is pathogenic microorganisms. So if you want to avoid the transmission of such diseases, then it is very essential to sterilize that particular products. Next important of sterilization is to prevent decomposition and spoilage of food and food products. We also know that there are that food products or food, these are spoiled by the different types of microorganisms. So to prevent this decomposition as well as spoilage of this food and food products, this sterilization process is carried out. The next one, to prevent the contamination of unwanted microbes in pure cultures and other microbiology experiments performed for research studies. So we know that there are so many experiments are there in our laboratories as well as in research institutes, and that experiment should be carried out, or that should be performed by using a pure cultures. And if these pure cultures are contaminated by unwanted microorganisms, so that process should go in waste as well as proper research cannot be carried out. So to prevent such contamination of unwanted microorganisms, that sterilization process is carried out. Next one, to prevent unwanted microbial contamination in antibiotic, enzyme, vitamins, fermentation and other industrial processes. Next important of sterilization is to prevent contamination in aseptic areas or in instruments which are used for the preparation of sterile dosage forms and sterility testing. So these are the some importance of sterilization. So here are some basic concepts which are very useful for the understanding of the sterilization techniques. So the first, as I told earlier, sterilization means it is a process by which an article, surface or medium is made free of all microorganisms, either in vegetative form or in spore form. So this is the definition of sterilization, that is a process by which that particular article, surface or medium, it is made free of all microorganisms just by killing of all these microorganisms present on that article, on that surface or in the particular medium. So that microorganisms may be present in the vegetative forms, or that may be present in the spore form, which is a highly resistant form. Second concept is disinfection. So it is a process of destruction of all pathogens or organisms which are capable of producing infections in living cells but not necessarily spores. And all these organisms may not be killed, but the number of these organisms is reduced to a level that is not harmful to the health. So disinfection में क्या किया जाता है कि ये एक प्रोसेस है डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ ऑल पैथोजेंस और ऑर्गेनिजम्स की जो इन्फेक्शंस कॉज करते हैं लिविंग सेल्स में. बट डिसइन्फेक्शन में जो स्पोर्स अगर वहाँ पे प्रेजेंट है तो उस स्पोर्स का डिस्ट्रक्शन वहाँ पे नहीं होता है. एंड ऑल ऑर्गेनिजम्स दैट कैनॉट बी किल्ड बाय यूजिंग दिस प्रोसेस, लेकिन इनका जो नंबर है पैथोजेंस का वो एक पर्टिकुलर लेवल तक कम किया जाता है जो कि बाद में हार्मफुल नहीं हो सकता. नेक्स्ट प्रोसेस है डेफिनेशन इज डिसइन्फेक्टेंट्स. सो दीज आर एंटी माइक्रोबियल एजेंट्स एंड दीज आर अप्लाइड टू द सर्फेस ऑफ नॉन लिविंग ऑब्जेक्ट्स टू डिस्ट्रॉय माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स दैट आर लिविंग ऑन द ऑब्जेक्ट्स. डिसइन्फेक्टेंट्स ये एंटी माइक्रोबियल एजेंट्स हैं. दिस दैट इज नथिंग बट दे आर अगेंस्ट दे फंक्शंस अगेंस्ट द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स और माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स एंड दे आर अप्लाइड ऑन द सर्फेसेस विच आर नॉन लिविंग, फॉर एग्जाम्पल टेबल्स और एनी अदर सर्फेस ऑफ नॉन लिविंग मटीरियल. एंड इट इज़ यूज टू डिस्ट्रॉय द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच आर प्रेजेंट ऑन दैट सब्सटेंसेस और सर्फेसेस. नेक्स्ट कंसेप्ट इज एंटीसेप्टिक. सो एंटीसेप्टिक्स आर केमिकल्स विच कैन बी सेफली अप्लाइड टू द लिविंग टिश्यूज एंड दीज आर यूज टू प्रिवेंट द इन्फेक्शन बाय इनिबिटिंग द ग्रोथ ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स. तो ये एंटीसेप्टिक्स क्या है? एंटीसेप्टिक्स एक प्रकार की केमिकल्स है जो लिविंग टिश्यूज और लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स के सरफेस पे अप्लाई कर सकते हैं और इनका मेन पर्पस है इन्फेक्शन को प्रिवेंट करना या इन्फेक्शन नहीं होने देना. एंड हाउ दीज एंटीसेप्टिक्स दे प्रिवेंट इन्फेक्शन, दे प्रिवेंट दैट इन्फेक्शन बाय इनिबिटिंग द ग्रोथ ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स. नेक्स्ट कंसेप्ट है असेप्सिस. सो असेप्सिस इज अ टेक्निक बाय विच द ऑकरेंस ऑफ इन्फेक्शन इन टू एन अनइन्फेक्टेड टिश्यू इज प्रिवेंटेड. नेक्स्ट है बैक्टेरिसिडल एजेंट्स और जर्मिसाइड्स. सो दीज बैक्टेरिसिडल एजेंट्स दीज आर द केमिकल सब्सटेंसेस विच आर एबल टू किल बैक्टीरिया और विच आर एबल टू किल जर्म्स. देयर इज अनदर कंसेप्ट इज ऑल्सो देयर, फॉर एग्जाम्पल वायरिसाइड्स और फंगिसाइड्स. फंगिसाइड्स का मतलब है दोज एजेंट्स विच किल्स द फंजाई. और बैक्टीरियोस्टैटिक का मतलब है दोज केमिकल एजेंट्स विच इनिबिट द ग्रोथ ऑफ बैक्टीरिया. स्टैटिक का मतलब है इनिबिट करना, ग्रोथ को इनिबिट करना. और फंगिस्टैटिक का मतलब है सो दोज एजेंट्स विच इनिबिट द ग्रोथ ऑफ फंजाई. सो दीज आर सम कंसेप्ट्स रिलेटेड टू दिस स्टरिलाइजेशन टेक्निक्स. देन this is the difference between antiseptics and disinfectant. So antiseptics, these are used for humans and animals. Disinfectants, these are used for non-living things like furniture and other household items. Then antiseptics, these are commonly found in healthcare centers or in hospitals. Disinfectants, they are commonly found in homes or in public places. Then antiseptics, these are cleanses wounds and surgical sites to prevent the infection as well as other complications. Then disinfectants, they kill microorganisms present on the surface of non-living material. Then these antiseptics, this includes mouthwash and cold sore and yeast infection treatment creams. Disinfectant includes cleaning products for houses as well as public places. Then these antiseptics, they transport through the lymphatic system and they destroy bacteria within the human body. Then there is disinfectants, they destroy the cell wall of microorganisms or they interfere with the metabolism of microbes. And antiseptics, they are not harmful to humans as well as animals, but these disinfectants, they are harmful to humans and animals. So this is the main difference between antiseptic and disinfectant. So the next point we will see here, that is why we need sterilization. स्टरलाइजेशन हमें क्यों करना है? सो ऑल ऑफ यू नो दैट दिस माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स दे आर एबल टू कॉज इन्फेक्शन और डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ डिसीजेस एंड दे आर कॉन्स्टेंटली प्रेजेंट इन द एक्सटर्नल एनवायरमेंट एंड ऑन द ह्यूमन बॉडी. Then microorganisms, they are also responsible for the contamination of important food products or vegetables or fermented food products, and they cause infection. So the main aim of sterilization is to remove or to destroy such microorganisms from the materials or from the surfaces. So how that microorganisms can be killed? Now we know that sterilization kills microorganisms, but how that sterilization kills microorganisms? First one, there is a denaturation of proteins. Proteins ka wahan pe denaturation hota hai, matlab jo normal protein hai, jo functional protein hai, wo non-functional ban jata hai, matlab baad mein wo function nahi kar sakta hai. So that is simply a denaturation process. Then interference with protein synthesis. So this sterilization process, it also inhibits the synthesis of proteins. Then interruption of DNA synthesis of repair. सिंथेसिस और रिपेयर मतलब बैक्टीरिया में माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स में जो भी डीएनए रेप्लिकेशन वहाँ पे होता है, डीएनए सिंथेसिस वहाँ पे होता है या फिर रिपेयरिंग वहाँ पे होता है, इस रेप्लिकेशन को रिपेयरिंग को ये स्टरलाइजेशन प्रोसेस इंटरप्ट करती है, सो दैट माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स गेट किल्ड. देन देर इज अ डैमेज टू द सेल एंड डिस्ट्रप्शन ऑफ सेल मेम्ब्रेन्स. सो दिस स्टरलाइजेशन प्रोसेस इट किल्स माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स बाय दिस डिफरेंट प्रोसेसेस, दैट इज डीनेचुरेशन ऑफ प्रोटीन्स, interference with protein synthesis, then interruption of DNA synthesis or DNA repair, then oxidative damage to the cell and disruption of cell membranes. Okay, next one. So there are some factors which influence the efficacy of disinfection or sterilization. Agar sabhi factors normal hai, matlab wahan pe present hai, so that process can or sterilization process can be occur, but there are some factors are there which can affect this killing of microorganisms by sterilization. For example, contact time. मतलब अगर proper contact time वहाँ पर मिला है उस microorganisms को kill करने को, उसी वक्त वहाँ पर microorganisms kill हो सकते हैं. So this contact time affect the disinfection process or it can affect the sterilization. Then physico-chemical environment. For example, pH. Then presence of organic material, temperature, then type of microorganisms, the number of microorganisms as well as material composition. So these are the factors which can affect the efficacy of this disinfection process or sterilization process. Then what to sterilize? Abhi sterilization kiska karna hai, kaun se material ka karna hai? So all instruments that penetrate soft tissues and bone, then instruments that are not intended to penetrate the tissues but that may come into contact with oral tissues, and if the sterilization procedure may damage the instruments, then sterilization can be replaced by disinfection processor. क्योंकि कुछ cases में अगर आप वहाँ पर sterilization कर रहे हो तो उस instrument को उस material को वहाँ पर damage हो सकता है, तो in such cases instead of sterilization there is a use of disinfection process or there is a use of disinfectant. So the next important point is methods of sterilization. अभी कौन से methods है sterilization के? तो principally there are two methods are there. One is physical method and second है chemical method. Physical method में अलग अलग methods वहाँ पे हैं. First one is dry heat sterilization और examples है incineration, direct flaming, red heat and hot air. मॉइस्ट हीट स्टरलाइजेशन जो है वहाँ पे है पाश्चराइजेशन, टिंडलाइजेशन एंड ऑटोक्लेविंग. स्टरलाइजेशन बाय रेडिएशंस में है यूज ऑफ अल्ट्रावायलेट लाइट, दैट इज यूवी लाइट विच इज़ अ नॉन आयोनाइजिंग रेडिएशंस. देन देर इज अ यूज ऑफ आयोनाइजिंग रेडिएशंस, फॉर एग्जाम्पल एक्सरेज, गामा रेज एंड बीटा रेज. एंड फोर्थ मेथड है फिजिकल मेथड में फिल्ट्रेशन और मैकेनिकल मेथड. एग्जाम्पल्स है एस्बेस्टॉस फिल्टर्स, जिसे हम सीड्स फिल्टर भी कह सकते हैं, सिंटर्ड ग्लास फिल्टर और मॉर्टन फिल्टर, देन फिल्टर कैंडल्स दैट इज सिरेमिक फिल्टर्स एंड मेम्ब्रेन फिल्टर्स दैट इज मिलीपोर फिल्टर्स. ये चार मेथड्स है फिजिकल मेथड्स. कौन से हैं? ड्राई हीट स्टरलाइजेशन, मॉइस्ट हीट स्टरलाइजेशन, स्टरलाइजेशन बाय रेडिएशंस एंड स्टरलाइजेशन बाय फिल्ट्रेशन और बाय यूजिंग मैकेनिकल मेथड्स. सेकंड यहाँ पे जो मेन मेथड है केमिकल मेथड्स, जिसमें है गैसियस स्टरलाइजेशन. एग्जांपल्स है ethylene oxide, formaldehyde and beta propiolactone. Second type of chemical method is sterilization by disinfectant, or we can say here chemicals, and it includes alcohols and aldehydes, phenols and halogens, then oxidizing agents as well as salts. So these are the main methods. So this is the graphical representation of these methods of sterilization here. Hot air on, then these are red hot, flaming and incineration. Then here autoclaving above 100 degree Celsius. Then moist state mein aata ye sab at 100 degree Celsius, below 100 degree Celsius. Below 100 degree Celsius mein aata pasteurization or incipiation. Then at 100 degree Celsius mein aata boiling and tinderization, and above 100 degree Celsius mein aata autoclaving. So these are the different methods for sterilization. So these are the radiations, that is hot sterilization, that is ultraviolet and infrared, and all these are the non-ionizing radiations. And cold sterilization, which includes x-rays or gamma rays, these are called as ionizing radiations. And baad mein chemical methods, which includes gaseous chemical method as well as liquids. Gaseous mein aata ethylene oxide, formaldehyde gas and beta propiolactone is also there. Liquid mein aata alcohol, phenol and lysol. To ye chemical methods hai. Uske baad hai filtration methods, which includes such filtration method, it is used when that material is heat labile, means it is heat sensitive. If that sterilizing material is heat sensitive, or if it is sensitive to the heat, then there is a use of filtration method. And that filtration methods includes candle filter, that is purification of water for drinking purposes, asbestos filter, that is single use disc, or in case of carcinogenic agents, sintered filter, that is which is expensive and easily brittle, and membrane filter, which is made up of cellulose ester, mainly used in microbiology, and average pore diameter is 0.22 millimeter. So this membrane filtration or filtration method, these are used to sterilize the materials which are sensitive to the heat, or we can say which are heat labile. Okay, see here physical method sterilization hai, dry heat, aur jo instrument wo abhi use kiya jata hai dry heat mein, iska naam hai ohon. We call that instrument as a hot air ohon, or simply it is called as ohon. Then moist heat, and the instrument which is used for moist heat, it is autoclave. And radiations, so the instrument which is used for radiation sterilization, this is called as gamma rays chamber. So here physical methods, so these physical methods, it involves process by the use of physical means or physical way, and here there is a utilization of heat in the presence or in the absence of heat, moisture, radiations or membrane filtration methods. Now the main physical method is dry heat sterilization. So heat, it is the most reliable and rapid method of sterilization. So how that heat kills the microorganisms, that includes, that in the, that means mechanism of heat, dry heat sterilization includes denaturation of proteins, oxidative damage and toxic effect of elevated levels of the electrolytes. Now the time which is required for sterilization by this dry heat sterilization, it is inversely proportional to the temperature of exposure. Matlab agar yahan pe temperature kam hai to sterilization ko jo time lagega wo zyada rahega. So it is inversely proportional. Agar temperature zyada hai, so the time which is required for sterilization, it will be less. And this time required for sterilization, it can be expressed as a thermal death time. So this thermal death time, it is the time, or it is the minimum time which is required to kill a suspension of microorganisms at a temperature at specific conditions. So these are the different methods of dry heat sterilization. The first one is sunlight and drying. So it is a traditional method of sterilization or food preservation. So action primarily due to the UV rays present on the sunlight, and effects vary due to the places. For example, natural method for sterilization of water in tanks, reservoir, lakes, etc. Second one is heat. So it is the most reliable method of sterilization and it should be the method of choice. Example, inoculating of wire loops, needles, forceps, etc. Third, dry sterilization, example a flaming. So just there is a passing or flame without allowing it to become red hot. For example, if you want to sterilize that nichrome wire loop, just you will pass that nichrome wire loop through that Bunsen burner flame. Or that culture tubes, both of the culture tubes can be sterilized just passing through the flaming or in flames. Then glass slides, scalpels, needles, cover slips. So all these can be sterilized just by passing through the Bunsen burner flames. Then incineration. So this is the excellent method for rapid destroying materials, for example pathological materials, contaminated cloths or animal carcasses. Okay, so this is about the very important instrument which is routinely used in microbiology laboratory, and that instrument, it is the example of dry heat sterilization, and this instrument, it is called as hot air oven. So these hot air ovens, these are electrical devices used in sterilization. The oven uses dry heat, as I told earlier, to sterilize the articles, and these instruments, these are operated from 50 degrees Celsius to 300 degrees Celsius, that is 122 Fahrenheit to 572 Fahrenheit. There is a thermostat which controls the temperature of this hot air oven. Then this is the most widely used method of sterilization by dry heat. The atoms which can be sterilized by using hot air oven, that includes glassware, forceps, scissors, scalpels, then all glass syringes, swabs, liquid paraffin, dusting powder, fats, as well as grease. But the nutrient media, it cannot be sterilized by using this hot air oven. Then it is not suitable for surgical dressing, rubbers, because that rubber can be melt at high temperature, that plastic, they can also melt at high temperature, then volatile and heat labile substances or heat sensitive substances. So these cannot be sterilized by using this hot air oven. See, this is the hot air oven or image of this hot air oven. See here, whatever that material you want to sterilize, it is kept here in this compartment. This is the knob which are useful for the controlling of this temperature here, and in this way that instrument is used for sterilization of materials. So what precautions you have to take if you are using this hot air oven? So the glassware should be dry, oven should not be overloaded, glass materials after drying are allowed to cool down before use, then articles are to be arranged in a manner to allow free circular of air, then door of the oven should be open after it cools down, that is after 2 hours. So this is the temperature time relation of this hot air oven. So if you are maintaining that 171 degrees Celsius temperature, then the time required to sterilize that materials, it is 60 degrees Celsius, 60 minutes. If the temperature is 160 degrees Celsius, then the time required for sterilization is 120 minutes. If the temperature is 150 degrees Celsius, then the time required for sterilization is 150 minutes. If the temperature is 140 degrees Celsius, then the time required for sterilization is 180 degrees Celsius. From this time temperature relation, you can observe there is an inverse relation, because when there is a temperature is more, then the time required is less. If the temperature is less, then the time required for sterilization is high. So in this way, there is a maintenance of time temperature relations when you are using hot air oven for sterilization. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of using this hot air oven. So what are advantages? So it is the suitable method for sterilization of substances which are destroyed by moisture. Then they do not require water, and there is not much pressure built up within the oven like the autoclave, making them safer to work with. Then it is suitable and easy to be used in laboratory environment, and they are much smaller than autoclaves, but can still be as effective. So these are the advantages of using hot air oven. Now there are some disadvantages are also there. So long heating time. So which are the disadvantages? The first disadvantage is long heating time and high temperature, and as they use dry heat instead of moist heat, there are some organisms like prions, they not be killed by this hot air oven or hot air every time. So this is about the hot air oven. Now in tomorrow's lecture we will see about the autoclave, or that is about moist heat sterilization. So if you are not subscribed this Microbiology by Santosh Napte, so kindly subscribe this YouTube channel and get updated with upcoming videos. Thank you.